Hi guys, welcome to our channel. In this video we are going to discuss about types of masonry walls. So for better understanding purpose, we divided the masonry walls into two types. They are based on materials and also based on bonding materials. So before we start, let me introduce myself. My name is Vinay, and if you are visiting my channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click the bell icon. Let's start our video. So based on material types, we have stone masonry, brick masonry, block masonry, gabion masonry, composite masonry, and reinforced masonry. And also based on bonding materials, we have cement mortar masonry, lime mortar masonry, and also mud mortar masonry. So we'll give quick introduction about all these. So we will give you best content in a small short video. What is stone masonry? Stones are the most durable material among all masonry units. They are laid down and bind together with the help of binding materials. These stones are rarely affected by environmental crisis, and they are not susceptible to fire, corrosion, winds, heat, etc. Based on geological formation of stones, they have 500,000 years of lifespan, which is great. And we have seen in India, there are many temples which were built with stone masonry, and the average age of construction is approximately 500 years. Okay, the other types of material in the stone masonry are rubble masonry and also ashlar masonry. So these are the subdivided in stone masonry. So next we'll discuss about brick masonry. We know we use most of the times brick masonry in our regular home constructions because it is most promising one. Brick masonry is done with burnt clay bricks, which are durable and strong. So they are used for a load bearing walls, and they are also used for frame structures also. So stones and bricks are best materials for load bearing walls. But when the height of the building increases, we have to increase the thickness accordingly. Okay, and bricks are weak in tension, so cracks are easily formed when compressive load increases. The size, number of bricks and joints plays a major role in the performance of bricks. And next we'll discuss block masonry. So the block masonry units are becoming more popular nowadays due to many reasons. I have discussed one now, and they are bigger and lighter, so they require less mortar and less number of joints, which in turn saves a lot of money. Types of block masonry: solid concrete block masonry, hollow concrete block masonry, AAC block masonry, CLC block masonry. So you can use these blocks for the masonry purposes. So these blocks are made from new age materials, and which saves fertile soil from being used for manufacturing of conventional bricks. So we are saving top fertile soil, which is eco-friendly. The block masonry is either reinforced or unreinforced. So if you use reinforcement in the middle of the block, then you can get rid of shear failures. So the block masonry will become more stronger and can withstand more shear loads. So that is the main advantage of using these hollow blocks for the masonry purposes. So there are many advantages. And next we'll discuss gabion masonry. So these gabions are baskets usually protected with a galvanized steel wire filled with fractured stones of medium size. And the gabion act as a single unit and are capable of resisting horizontal forces. They are mostly used as retaining walls and also for aesthetic purposes. Gabion masonry has the advantage of good drainage, as they are resistant to flood, frost, and soil erosion. Their expected life depends mainly on mesh, and it increases if we use best corrosive resistant material, composite masonry. Masonry which is constructed with the help of two or more materials is known as composite masonry. In composite masonry, we use two widths. Width is a vertical section of masonry. You can see in the picture, there are two widths, and one width can be brick, and other width can be a hollow or any other material. So these two bits are joined with the help of reinforcement. And next, the composite masonry may be adopted due to the following reasons: to use available material for the maximum economy or to improve the appearance of the building. Next, reinforced masonry. Reinforced masonry is a process of installing steel reinforcement in the form of reinforcing bars and placed in the holes of the blocks, then filled with concrete or grout. So the reinforcement increases the tensile strength of masonry and can withstand horizontal forces like seismic loads. So the ductility of the masonry increases significantly, which allows them to deform prior to breaking. Reinforced masonry walls can be load-bearing or non-load-bearing walls. Next, we'll discuss types of masonry with mortar. So masonry with cement mortar. And mixing cement with sand and water will give cement mortar, which is an adhesive and helps in binding various materials. Cement mortar is a very strong binding material that helps the joints to attain greater strength to resist maximum loads. So for the masonry walls, we prefer cement mortar instead of any other available mortar. Next, masonry with lime mortar. Lime mortar is made of lime, water, and sand. This lime is mainly used for conservation of the old buildings and recreation of the new buildings using traditional techniques. And lime is more porous than cement, so most of the time we prefer cement mortar. Next, masonry with mud mortar. Mud is the first invented mortar and used for binding of stones from hundreds of years ago. If we use mud as a mortar, we can reduce the cost of masonry construction by 22%, but the mud mortar is not resistant to weathering and other environmental hazards, so we are not preferring mud as a mortar. So in this video, we learnt about what are the types of masonry walls based on material types and also based on mortar types. If you like our video, please share it with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click the bell icon. See you in the next video. Thank you.